Was Deputy David Anderson's death a waste? Let's analyze this. Lethal One here with another Resident Evil 7 discussion video. Anderson was in charge of patrolling around Dovey following a series of disappearances. He reaches the house where he begins to investigate, and I'm not exactly sure if that was him calling the Bakers or not, but after a few minutes he meets Ethan. Now this is where I get annoyed with Mr. Anderson's behavior. He meets a hysterical young man who's begging for his gun. Now if that was me, I would first back away from the house and then I would call for backup. I would wait for the backup to arrive and then I would meet the weird man in the garage. I mean, his job was to patrol that area, so he was already aware of the kidnappings and the disappearances. Ethan flat out told him there was crazies in there and he was fighting for his life. Okay, let's play devil's advocate anyways. Ethan the asshole could have said clearly that they captured me or they kidnapped me. Hey man, they kidnapped me. That probably would have sparked a light bulb in Mr. Anderson's head to do something useful. Again, like call for backup. Also, he might have thought that he was being YouTube pranked or something. I know in our world that's pretty common. So maybe in his world that's pretty common too. So maybe he thought that he was walking into a prank or something. Worst case scenario, he could have called for backup, and if his backup and him would have walked into the garage and found out that they were being pranked, I mean, they could have went to town on the pranksters. I'm talking about A-Town stomped the crap out of Ethan.
I hope your body cam off.
Yes, his death was a waste for two reasons. Normally when a cop's radio goes cold, backup is sent automatically. And for some reason in this world, that didn't happen. I estimate by the time Ethan made it to the D-Series arm, that the place would have been swarming with cops. Lucas would have fled before he even had time to kidnap his sister Zoe, and Zoe could have made the serum, and both Zoe and Mia would have made it out alive. Umbrella moves in on Evie. The second reason his death was such a disaster is because in terms of gameplay, I believe he was intended to be a boss character in the game. I don't know if time constraints had him cut, but if you look at the game or the dialogue, Jack is talking to the corpse and he says that he's gonna help him catch Ethan.
I'll find him and I will make him suffer.
Look closely at his body, it's being turned into molded. All that set up for his head to end up in the refrigerator, and that was the end of his chapter. It's too bad time constraints cut him out of the game. But I don't know, maybe I'm thinking too deep into this. On a positive note, if it was him calling on the phone, at least he helped Ethan escape that face carving. I mean, in a way, he also gave Ethan the snake key, so I guess, oh geez, I'm undecided again. So, I mean, this was definitely a Friday the 13th type of death, but let me know what you guys think. Until next time, guys, peace.